Previously on Canada's Next AOR.
New era of collaboration and cooperation between Ottawa and Quebec City.
Here, you can see the cut lines on deck 5 on both sides here as the workers progress and prepare for the lifting off of the old and in parallel are building the new.
We are at the Champlain Dry Dock at Chauncey Davie, and we're awaiting the arrival of motor vessel Asterix. It's the exciting next phase of its conversion into a Resolve Class AOR. It's going to be in this dry dock, which is Canada's largest dry dock, in 2 days, and will remain in the dry dock for the next 14 months while we complete the conversion.
Everything goes according to plan, and it's even better, I would say.
Well, they're setting things up to be very successful in terms of high levels of pre-outfit on the steel sections in the shop prior to going to the ship, which bodes well for being a highly successful project.
So for young people like me, it's a good project.
It's the future of Davie. It's only that. It's the last contract, the big contract we have now. We have to make. We are proud people, proud worker on that. And that's all mean for me.
You know, it's incredible how people are now galvanized and how this project is proving to the critics and to those who think we couldn't do it that we're actually doing it and making it happen. And this is really important. I think it's changed the whole attitude of people in the yard. It's changed the attitude of government officials who are administering the contract. They come to the yard, they see the progress, and they're taken aback by just how far along we are and how professional the project's being executed. Fun on this in Davie and on the project is the feeling of community we've got. We've got folks from all across Canada who come here, set down roots, met partners, have had kids. They love the work. There's a great ambiance. People are working hard. Great sense of community. They're very proud of the area. They're proud to be here in Lévis. They're proud to be in Quebec. They're proud to be Canadians. We've got people literally from coast to coast, and it's phenomenal. And the sense of teamwork, which in part is derived from, you know, a lot of people saying you'll never get it, you'll never make this happen. And so the sense of achievement of finally being able to prove the naysayers wrong is really motivating people. It's fantastic.
It's May 2016. The team at Davie have made incredible progress on the project, and it is currently running at more than 10% ahead of schedule. Like clockwork, as soon as the ship was docked earlier in the year, the Davie team set to work and removed the superstructure and container guides. There to oversee the preparation of the vessel for the conversion are Rolls-Royce, one of Davie's key engineering partners for Project Resolve.
This job started at the worst part of the year in Canada. It was beginning of this year and it was so cold, so much snow. And quite amazing. Great working, hard working people that are going to make this project worthwhile. And all the things that those people are doing and did and what will they do is just astonishing. Astonishing, because all the hard weather and all the ice and all the snow, now the sun, the conditions on the boat are really extreme. You have to be here to sense and just to feel it, the heat now during the summer, but also during the winter is really, I admire those people working on this boat. Not anybody can do that.
June 2016, and it's out with the old and in with the new. The time has come to begin cutting steel on the new sections for the ship. Federal, provincial, and municipal politicians have gathered with senior naval officers and government personnel at Davie for the traditional steel cutting ceremony.
La Resolve, ce sera le plus grand navire en opération de la flotte de la Marine Royale. C'est quand même fantastique. Mais il faut constamment le répéter, le répéter, le répéter. Chantier Davie est le plus grand constructeur naval du Canada et le plus expérimenté. C'est ça qui est fantastique.
Et le développement de ces chantiers, l'expertise du Québec. Alors, on est fiers participants à ce rendez-vous-là aujourd'hui. Longue vie à la Davie et la collaboration du gouvernement du Québec vous est acquise aujourd'hui. Merci beaucoup.
Finalement, je vous remercie de votre présence ici aujourd'hui à nouveau et je partage avec vous à nouveau ma conviction profonde que vous tous, travailleurs de notre région, saurez faire de ce contrat historique un véritable succès pour notre région et pour notre pays maintenant et à plus long terme. Merci beaucoup.
The yard has done some fantastic work. It's actually amazing the cooperation between the plate shop, the construction shop, and the pipe shop, and the engineering to lead them to this.
In order to take advantage of the summer weather conditions and remain ahead of schedule, work is now well underway on Davie's production lines, constructing the ship's new tank sections to be installed in the cargo holds. Each section has to be built with microscopic precision. Inside the tanks are a complex network of pipes, which will move ship fuels, aviation fuels, fresh water, and ballast water around the vessel as needed. Before the tanks are installed onboard the ship, workers complete the installation of underdeck strengthening in order to comply with the latest in safety and environmental standards. Then, as each tank section is completed, they are transported to the ship and installed.
All these are modules, they are tanks. They're all, as you know, we have to carry over 7,000 tons of usable F-76 diesel fuel for RAD, and that's what those tanks will have. And the top of those tanks create the tween deck, so you can see that as well.
Over the course of the summer, each tank is installed in the ship. Another new part of the ship will be the new generator room, where extra power will be installed in the ship. Work is underway to get the space ready for installation of the engines at the end of the summer. While the work continues onboard the ship, Davie's procurement and logistics teams work around the clock to ensure that the construction teams have the parts and services they need when they need them.
Fortunate at Davie, over the years, we've got over 700, nearly 700 Canadian suppliers in 8 provinces, and 550 of those suppliers are based in Quebec.
And choosing suppliers is about more than just who is the cheapest.
The things we look at when we're looking for something to buy, you know, what we're going to buy, where we're going to buy it, is A, has the material been, is it compatible with the other Navy ships that are going to be in the field? Obviously, for the Royal Canadian Navy, if the ship's going to be in use for 40 years, they'd like to have common suppliers, common spares. There's some economies of scale to be achieved there, so we have to think about that.
One of the key goals of Project Resolve has been to showcase the best of Canadian industry, and at the same time, ensuring that the systems being installed on board the ship are fully interoperable with those in the rest of the Navy's future fleet. Companies throughout Canada are working to deliver these vital systems. One of the first companies Davie and Federal Fleet Services engaged with when developing the program was Hepburn, another Canadian success story.
Hepburn has been a supplier of replenishment equipment to the Canadian Navy for over 40 years. We supplied the original equipment for the two ships, Protector and Preserver. It's a testament to the longevity of that equipment that it was still fully operational when the ships were retired from service quite recently. Approximately 45 years of continuous service around the world in all kinds of weather.
I'm very proud to work on this project to deliver the next generation of replenishment at sea equipment that will service the Royal Canadian Navy for years to come.
Another key supplier is L3 Maps in Montreal, who are providing the Naval Integrated Platform Management System.
Controls the main systems on the ship, the propulsion, the electrical, monitoring of all alarms, damage control, fire detection on the ship.
Project Resolve is a very exciting project for us because, first of all, it's the first real AOR that we are doing. Secondly, it's an opportunity for my company, L3 Maps, to demonstrate our ability to not only provide the Navy systems for which we are so familiar, but show the flexibility of our approach and show how suitable it is for this type of ship conversion. Because I believe that we will see many more of these type of ship conversion projects in the world in the future.
On the other side of Canada, in British Columbia, two other companies are working hard on their deliverables for the project. OSI Maritime in Burnaby were awarded the contract to build the ship's integrated navigation and tactical systems.
At the moment, OSI is in the production phase of the integrated bridge and navigation system for Resolve. We take the heritage directly from the Arctic Offshore Patrol Ship Program. So it's a classic example of the IRB policy working in Canada, where we're able to pull through technology into future ship design. At the moment, we're scheduled to be delivering the first ship set at the beginning of December, and I'm pleased to say that we are on track to achieve that. Resolve is a large, innovative ship. The approach that Davie has taken is extremely interesting, and it's allowed us to position directly onto two other AOR-style programs, both which are in the Southern Hemisphere. One, hopefully, that will be awarded shortly by a South Korean yard, and more excitingly, OSI was awarded a contract with Navantia for the C-1654 program in Australia, where we were able to demonstrate our ability to integrate into platforms of the Resolve's size.
Another company which is bringing cutting-edge training methods to the crew of Federal Fleet Services and the Royal Canadian Navy is RaceRock's 3D in Victoria. By training crews in virtual reality, they can become entirely familiarized with a ship and its systems before they have even stepped foot on board.
One of the great things about Project Resolve is that we're being able to follow the future naval training strategy and implement technologies such as virtual reality and gamification.
Project Resolve has allowed us to grow our internal team and capabilities here in Victoria, and has also allowed us to work with some of the best SMEs from Eastern Canada.
With Federal Fleet, they really encourage the Tier 1s to work together, and in our case, as an SME, to work with some of the bigger clients that already have export opportunities, build training for their systems, and then in the future, export them to the world.
It is really rewarding to be working on the first naval training system of the digital learning age.
In order to allow the team at Davie to focus on the conversion of the ship itself, it is working with its partners, world-leading modular accommodation specialists, Amoco, to deliver the accommodation for the ship. As part of this new way of working, Amoco is undertaking a massive knowledge-sharing exercise, which will lead to a permanent presence at Davie to deliver world-class accommodation modules for future programs.
Well, the basic steel construction is a standard proven technique. The thing that's unique about this particular construction is the cabins and the fact that Amoco specializes in building the cabins completely off-site. And then once the steel work's done, the background outfitting's done, the cables and duct work are in place, then the cabins come in very quickly. And the speed of the progress ramps up very fast as all the cabins come in. They're hooked up and construction's completed on those individual units. The current progress on a percentage basis is about 72% today. It does look very much completed on the outside with the exception of some exterior painting yet to be done to finish the touch up there. But inside, it's progressing quite well. There's six different decks that are all progressing at different levels from the galley down below to the accommodation decks up above.
Almaco's background in building marine accommodation for everything from offshore drilling platforms to five-star luxury cruise ships will ensure that Canada's Navy will be provided unrivaled comfort and safety.
It's a better feeling for the crew, and well, I think we have succeeded quite well in that.
Let's just wait and see, and I'm sure that the people eventually working in the unit will be amazed with what they receive.
It's November 2016, and back at Davie, it's time to install the new generators. These massive generators will be used to power all the new systems on board, such as the replenishment at sea equipment, retractable thruster, and the accommodation. With nearly all the tanks and piping now installed below deck, the teams are now installing the main deck before the winter sets in. The sense of achievement at Canada's largest shipbuilder is clear. Join us next time on Canada's Next AOR.